I used to be the girliest girl. Blonde and curvy and dresses, handbags, heels. These days, I'm this kind of chubby, hairy guy, but I'm so happy. Like, I wake up every morning and I'm like, yes.
People grow up and they want to be, you know, say like a doctor or like an astronaut. I grew up wanting to be a woman.
Thousands of people in Britain believe they were born the wrong sex.
I've got these pants that have like a little pouch in the front.
And now they're doing everything they can to change their gender.
That's what makes me a man, and without that, I would still look female.
But becoming a man or turning into a woman can set the world against you, and it's full of risk.
My family totally flipped out and were not supportive and did some really, really horrible things.
Where's your balls, man?
I shouldn't have to go through this, it's not my fault. I could easily just go back to being a boy, but then that'd be for everyone else, that wouldn't be for me.
So, this summer, seven people came together to help each other change sex. They took time off from the big bad world to create a safe haven.
I took so many hormones, I turned into a fanny.
To me, it's too round.
They each took big steps towards changing their bodies.
This is insane. Look at this one.
Oh, my God.
This is female to male finished. I'm the end of the process.
That's a cock to be proud of.
I don't want a huge one because I feel like it would sort of be a bit intimidating.
Sarah, you're my hero!
And they supported each other through the challenges of being transsexual.
My family don't know about me yet. I want to tell them next week, actually.
Really?
Yeah.
In the first weekend at the retreat...
I think I look like a bad tranny.
Sarah, who's only just started living as a woman, gets the help she needs. And Karen finally gets the genital surgery she's always wanted.
My body will finally match how I've felt for years.
This summer, seven people helped each other take on the world.
To the magic Tranny Seven. Tranny!
From Brighton to Merseyside, seven people are packing for their first weekend together.
It'll be the first time I've ever met anyone who's transgendered and who's my own age. I hope there's, like, people that are like me.
Drew's been living as a woman for the past 5 years, and it's made her life in Wakefield almost impossible.
Come on! Where's your balls, man?
I've probably got bigger balls than you.
Wait.
You don't know what people are going to be like, you know, when, like, you're walking past them, like, they could easily, like, turn around and, like, hit you if they know what you are.
Drew still lives at home with her mum, but her decision to change gender has left her isolated. She desperately needs friends and a career.
I just feel like everyone's life's moving forward and mine's just stuck, like, in the same position that it was, like, 5 years ago before I came out. There's personal things that, like, you can't really talk about to, like, an ordinary person because they wouldn't understand. It's hard and it's lonely.
I think you can feel very isolated sometimes. You're one trans person walking around in a world of 6 billion non-trans people. So I'm really looking forward to being in a space where there's going to be people who have a shared experience.
It's August. Seven transgendered people are on their way for the first of 5 weekend retreats that'll be held over the course of the summer.
It's like everyone's dream home. It's like a fairy tale house.
First to arrive is Drew.
I hope I'm not like the trashy one compared to everyone, like the overly done one.
Donna's next. Like Drew, she's been a woman for 5 years, but she's louder and prouder about changing her sex.
I think I've brought too many clothes. It's a bit girly. For a tranny, I'm a bit manly.
And she's bringing some strong views to the retreat about what it is to be a trans woman.
Am I a man or a woman? I don't think I'm either. I believe there's a third sex. It's nice to be able to have cleavage. I live my life daily as a woman. Oh, girl.
But it doesn't mean that without my clothes on, I look like a woman or look like a man, you know? Some of us, you know, have more than others, you know? I can't go into all that. I'm not spelling it out for you.
Another car. How exciting.
It won't just be women at the house.
He's quite funky.
Lewis became a man 3 years ago.
It's huge, isn't it?
No one has ever mistaken me for a female or been able to tell that I'm transgender. So when I tell people, they're always shocked.
Fox has only just started becoming a man.
I'm Lewis.
Fox, nice
Fox,
to meet you.
No, nice to meet you. Yeah.
Right before I came here, I was like, I'm in doubt, do you know what I mean?
What were you thinking about, like?
Because reality hit me that I'd be revealing to everyone loads of, like, private things,
yeah.
and everyone would know as well that, yeah. you know, like, transgender.
But Fox has very different worries. Being so early in his transition, people struggle to tell if he's male or female.
It's a really awkward time, but it was kind of do or die for me. And so I know that I've got to go through this to get to a place where my outside reflects my inside.
I assumed that Fox was a transgender guy.
Yes,
he looked like a guy, so I just assumed. If I've got it wrong, then I'm very sorry.
Hello, I'm Lewis.
Hi, it's Miss Andrew.
I'm Fox.
Hello.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you. Someone's getting in. Quick.
Hi.
How are you?
Third man into the retreat is Max. He's done the most to become male.
Andrew, it's nice to meet you.
I have no shoes on.
This is amazing.
Could this be my bedroom?
All of them have had to weigh up the likely risks of coming out as transgender on television.
Are you all glad you've come in then?
Yeah.
Did any of you have, like, reservations? Because, like, my worry was that, like, even though I get shit, you know, like, on the street now, by doing this, it would make it a lot worse because I'd be open to everyone about it.
If you're out and trans, it almost gives people a license and they can ask you whatever they want.
Like their curiosity is just open season.
Like, the amount of guys that come up to me and just go, are these real? And grab my tits.
Yeah. As soon as you explain to them, like, how would you feel if I met your mum and was like, so, how's your junk, you know?
Yeah.
What have you got between your legs? You would be
exactly.
so upset if yeah, you said that to your mum or your sister or...
I think I come across as, like, a hugely confident person, but I'm always nervous all the time. Based on 2009 statistics, a trans person is murdered somewhere in the world every 72 hours. And I think I experience a certain degree of fear most of the time. Here, maybe not so much. We'll find out.
Someone's coming in.
Yay!
Hi.
Hiya.
What's your name?
I'm Sarah.
Sarah,
nice to meet you.
Hello.
Sarah's 29. She's only just started living full-time as a woman. She hasn't even dared to tell her parents yet.
Yeah, we're sort of attacking you as you come in.
Hello.
I am Lewis.
Hello.
Nice to meet you.
You alright?
Yeah.
Cool.
Hi, Sarah.
Hiya.
Nice to meet you.
Hello. Oh, wow. This is really cool.
Hi,
Sarah.
Hiya. Hi, sweetie. Have a glass of wine.
Oh, amazing.
Have you got the wine? You're not in AA, anyone, are you? Because if you are, you should have a drink.
Completing the group is Karen.
Yay! Hi, I'm Sarah.
See you later.
Hi, Karen, I'm Fox.
Fox.
Nice to meet you.
And you too.
Hiya, I'm Lewis. Nice to meet you.
She's spending the weekend at the retreat before going to hospital. There, she'll have the genital surgery she's wanted for years. It'll be a landmark for her in becoming a woman.
I just can't wait. Even though I know I am a woman, I still have got that part of me left that still says, you're male.
Yes! Is this everyone then?
Yeah, I think so.
Right, to
Tranny Seven.
To the magic Tranny Seven.
Tranny!
To the trannies!
This summer, seven transsexual people are meeting for the first time. They've come together to help and support each other as they change gender.
Yesterday, when I went shopping, there was, like, these two, like, girls.
Yeah.
There was, like, is that a boy or a girl? Ha-ha! I look at you and I think, like, I would never guessed with you.
You look really great, like, honestly.
Yeah, I always think when people are like, because I never would have guessed. I'm like, oh, no. Come on.
Being all trans together means that they can talk openly about their new identities.
Choosing a name was so hard for me.
Was it?
Yeah.
What other names did you think of?
I created a short list.
Of how many?
Like 100 names. and my best friend Liz. She was like, Max, I hate to break it to you, but these names are all a bit pansy.
Oh.
I was like, no, they're lovely names. And she was like, Timothy, pansy.
Are you in the garden?
Good crowd. Bloody good crowd. There are some nutty ones, though.
Woohoo!
Donna, for one. She's definitely going to be a handful.
Girl, you're such a hoe, I love it.
Seeing someone like Lewis, he gives me major beard envy, obviously. And yeah, he's quite hench as well. He's good at his bench pressing and stuff like that.
You are quite cute, though.
Thanks. You're embarrassed. No, but...
Look at him trying to change subject.
Yeah, so anyway.
Right, so those ones are taken.
To mark the start of the retreat, a room's been turned into a photo studio.
Look, here's the camera.
Oh, no.
No.
I can't wait. Come on, boys and girls, let's take pictures of you. Look at that. Ooh. Oh.
It's up to the group how they use it.
Girl, you're such a hooker. Batman.
Woohoo!
Being in front of the camera is very intimidating. I think a lot about how my body will look to other people and if they will be judging me.
So big. Ready? Look at you. Wow. Oh, go for it.
It's nice to be in a group where you're the best looking woman. Is that really mean? No, it's not mean if it's true though, is it?
Yeah.
I look at photographs of me now and I'm really happy with like how masculine I look. And it just feels like sort of somebody else, really, when I'm looking back at old photos. It's like me dressing up as a girl for, like, an act or something.
Scream at each other.
Very confident in
your shame. Yeah. I fucking hate figuring.
Oh, I don't know.
Just be yourself.
Best photos of me is when I didn't even know the photo was being taken. I'm just grinning like a twat.
Just be natural. Sarah,
do you want to do it?
Not really. They all look amazing. They really do. And it just makes me more aware of what I see as my failings.
My God, it's hot in here.
I think I look like a bad tranny.
Just 4 weeks ago, Sarah moved from her home in Jersey to start a new life in the UK.
Got everything I own in my car. Got all my clothes, and that's about it. Don't have much belongings.
Jersey has no medical facilities to help her change her gender, so moving is the best way she could get the hormone treatment she needs to become a woman.
What's the name, sir?
For years I was ashamed of it and I hid it from anyone. There's still parts that you can't really speak to people about. And there's still parts that you have to keep hidden. Everything changes.
After she arrived in Britain, Sarah headed for Swansea. She knew no one, but in her rented room, she finally felt free to start living full-time as a woman.
Where are my boobs? These are my very dirty silicone boobs. I don't like them very much. I don't like the way they feel, but they give a really good illusion under clothes. I'll show you a little trick. What you do is you pull them out, and then you basically pull all the fat from under your armpits, and you just kind of squidge it in, and with a tight bra, you're left with a bit of a cleavage. This definitely is how it should be. I'm still very much a guy in a dress. There's a long, long road ahead of me, but there is no future for me as a guy. I don't fit in. I'm not comfortable. I hate myself. But
dressing up in a dress, you know, it gives me hope. Hope for a better life for myself.
Pose, come on.
I don't pose. No, I'm just a drunk.
Just be yourself, Sarah.
Right. Yeah. Put your hand on your hip.
Right, put your legs like that.
Just give me an ass.
Arms forward.
Put your legs straight.
Tilt your pelvis.
Put your left arm onto your
stick your tits in the air.
And then move your hips to the side.
We've all been at the same place as Sarah in our transition, and the minute I saw her come into the house, I was like, right, I want to personally be the one to make sure she's okay. I think we can all use help sometimes.
Say yeah. Sausages.
Look at that. Yeah.
While the photographs are developed, everyone's downstairs helping to get dinner ready. But the photo shoot has upset Fox and reminded him how far he has to go to become a man.
I think that perhaps being in this house with a bunch of trans people, I can't really help but compare myself to other people. I'm the earliest on my stage of the guys that are here. And it's just really obvious. I kind of feel not embarrassed, but I feel kind of bad about that.
In the bath and pretend that, yeah.
The photographs are ready. Now they'll be able to judge themselves and each other.
No one look at it until we all sit down.
Together.
Yeah.
Go! Oh my God, I look so glam! I've never looked so good.
Let's see.
You look bloody good.
Oh, wow. I think you should be proud. You look quite cute and like innocent.
I've never liked photos of me. I've never liked mirrors or I've never liked to look at myself. I've got fake hair, I've got fake boobs, and I've got a horrible nose. I feel different on the inside than how I look on the outside, you know?
These pictures, like, symbolise a point in our transition. Yeah. And, like, by the end of this, we might be different and we can compare.
I don't like it.
Why do you not like it?
Why?
You look double hard.
Yeah, it's cool.
I think. You look like a chav.
Hey, I feel so much better about tonight.
There ain't no wrong with chav. Do you know what? No, you have.
Donna said I look like a chav. And Sarah said that I looked well hard, which is two things I just don't associate with myself. I'm like a geeky Jewish book nerd that likes vegan cooking and crafts. I'm a well hard chav and I really like reading the Bible. I studied a really good piece of the Talmud the other day. Yeah! What are you looking at? You know?
I feel really vain because I really like my photo.
No, you should. It's absolutely brilliant.
I think I look really girly, so I don't like it at all. I don't have a beard or anything.
Yeah, well, not all guys have a beard.
A beard doesn't make a man, though,
eh? No. I didn't like the way I looked. I didn't like the bags under my eyes. I don't know, I didn't really like how feminine I look.
And I am impatient to change.
Isn't that... Oh, look at us. That.
It's Saturday, 7 a.m., and Drew is the first to get up. The morning is the most difficult part of her day.
When I first wake up in the morning, when I look in the mirror, like, I don't really see the person I want to be. Like, I just see, like, someone else. I think that's why I wear lots of makeup, just to, like, kind of cover that. I did learn on my own, like, I looked at loads of pictures of, like, Jodie Marsh and people in the glamour model industry. They're, like, seen as the most, like, desirable women. And to me, you know, that's what I wanted to achieve with my look.
Oh, look.
At home in Wakefield, Drew's mum has helped her son become a woman.
Hiya, you're all right.
All right. Yeah.
Which one?
The end, French manicure. When Drew started doing her transition, the makeup was very, very OTT.
Thank you.
She always walked with her head down. And I said to her, you need to hold your head up, because people are going to look and say, is it a boy or is it a girl?
I know deep down that I've got man features, you know, like, but I think the makeup kind of tries to disguise that, kind of like a mask. The more you have on, like, the more you feel like a woman.
So like every other morning, Drew will spend the next 2.5 hours in front of the mirror. In their rooms, the other women prepare themselves for the day.
I'm going to start hairy hands.
I don't know whether the girls, the girls in bed or... No,
I imagine that they've got the palette out. Right? Is that what they're doing?
Yeah. Did you have to work? Did you work?
I will make up, yeah. And I don't miss it at all, but I do... think it's a little bit unfair, like if girls have got like a pimple or, you know, they can cover it up and feel better about it, whereas when you're a bloke you just have to like man up.
In his room, Fox is frustrated by what he sees in the mirror.
When I look in the mirror in the morning, I think I look just like a dyke. I think I look like a lesbian. I look like a butch woman.
Fox wants a man's physique, so he always hides his breasts by wearing a chest binder.
I put this on because when I wear shirts, I prefer the way it looks like that, kind of like flat, like a male chest. If I don't bind, I feel weird, I feel strange.
On their first day at the retreat, they'll spend time getting to know each other.
Have you got a pencil sharp?
But Drew won't come out until she thinks she looks perfect.
I feel like I'm actually, like, decent enough to actually go out. I know I probably look like I should be going on a night out, but I don't care.
There's one more vital element to Drew and Donna's morning routine. Both have been taking the female hormone estrogen for 2 years. It's made massive changes.
I think with, like, hormones... they make you feel more comfortable. Because before, like, you're not on hormones, you just feel like a boy.
Especially with, like, breast growth and things like that. That really helps. That gives you a whole different lease of life, doesn't it?
Yeah. You can really feel, like, all the breast tissue inside, because I thought they were, right, soft, but when you feel mine, quite...
Yeah, mine are, like... Mine are soft, but apart from in...
I've never felt boobs before.
Well, exactly.
Like, I don't know if that's what they're supposed to feel like.
I've had breast growth, my skin's got softer, my hair's gone really nice, and, you know, to be a bit vain, that's quite nice. I would like some other things, though, maybe a boob job. A bigger bum would be nice.
Hello.
How are you?
I'm all right.
Are you ready for your shot?
Yes.
Upstairs, there's some male bonding going on. Lewis has asked Fox to help him inject his testosterone.
I hate smashing these little vials. Like, do you think I'd cut my fingers sometimes to it over? That's what makes me a man, and without that, I would still look female. I wouldn't have facial hair. I probably wouldn't be as muscular. My voice would still be very, very high. Well, it's meant to increase your sex drive, but I've always had a big sex drive anyway, so...
Without hormones, I... never would have been able to pass as a man. I would never have been able to experience and grow in my kind of male identity. It was probably the most important part of my medical transition.
By injecting testosterone, the boys are forcing their bodies to go through male puberty. It has the effect they want, but it's like a second adolescence.
I don't think it really affects my mood, but I certainly notice that I get... it affects my skin. So we'll be, like, spotty and grumpy at the same time.
Cool, that's perfect.
About there, yeah. You know where to do it, don't you?
Yeah. You ready?
You want to do it about there?
Yeah.
Okay, cool. So all the way in, okay, dead fast. Okay. No, okay, cool. That didn't hurt at all, actually.
Fox has got the magic touch, eh?
No, have you done it already?
Yeah.
You're fast, aren't you? My mum does it, she takes ages because she's trying to get everything right. She's like...
Oh, bless. Your mum does it for you.
Well.
Oh, it's a good job I've got a big ass.
There you go.
Do you want a plaster?
No.
Just a wiggle, make sure it's in.
Yeah. You all right?
Yeah.
Good. Hi, darling.
Cool. Did you sleep all right?
Yeah.
It's mid-morning. And they've got together to talk about the drugs they're taking to make them into men and women.
I took so many hormones, I turned into a fanny. It was like, do you know what I mean? Just everything was just emotional. It's like, you're watching television. Oh, you know, I really like her jumper. It's really nice.
Oh,
and you start crying. Yeah. And you're like, where has this come from?
When I first started testosterone, it took me ages before I could... I don't know, it was weird. There was one time when I felt really upset. I felt like I needed to cry, you know, to get it out. And no tears came out. I was like, what's up with me?
I do worry sometimes, especially when I'm in situations with women, that, you know, like where we're arguing or discussing, I feel like I've become very like, bloody single-minded, you know? Like, I know what I'm saying. And this girl that I used to live with, she'd be like, you're bullying me. And I'm like, I'm not bullying you. She's like, you're not listening to what I'm saying. And I'm like, I am listening, but I'm right. You're not listening to me.
You're such a man.
You know, whereas before, as a woman and as a lesbian, you know, we'd sit down and we'd have a cup of tea. And we'd listen and we'd listen to each other.
There was a lot of laughing and joking going on today, and transitioning can be quite isolating and hard and really, really not funny at times. But it's so nice to meet these people that just kind of take the lighter side of life.
What I love about it is the fact that I've got people to support me who are like me, and all my like worries have just gone out the window.
No, Sarah's room is smaller than mine.
We all kind of make a group together, which is nice. It's a good bunch of black sheep in a way.
It's Saturday afternoon at the retreat, and most of the group are messing about on the river.
Help me, I'm a cross-dresser.
I'm the same.
Help me.
No, don't, we're going to come in.
Such hard work being on a boat. Let me tell you, I'm exhausted.
You know that one there, I think.
Tomorrow, Karen will leave early for hospital to have gender reassignment surgery. Her penis will be inverted to give her the vagina she has always wanted.
People say to me, you're brave, I really admire what you're doing, but it's not courage. It's a belief in yourself that you're doing something that you know you've got to do, basically.
Karen felt she was female from the age of 9, but spent her life fighting it. She actively sought out traditional male roles, working as a truck driver and a policeman.
I've always tried to do jobs that would take the female away from me. And it is because you're trying to hide. You're trying to become normal. I was in relationships as a bloke. I got married and did all the normal things that blokes are supposed to do, but I just didn't feel right. I'm just a woman. It's a woman that I should have been when I was a lot younger, a lot younger.
Finally, at the age of 49, Karen decided to change her gender permanently. Tomorrow's operation comes after 2 years of tough psychiatric assessment.
It is major invasive surgery, and it can go wrong, but I hope it doesn't. I want to wake up.
We have heat. Oh, God, hang on. That's it.
I've read a lot about the procedures and stuff like that. But, like, what do they actually do?
They cut down the penis.
Yeah.
They use the skin on the outside and a tip of the top of the penis as the clitoris. So they keep all the nerves intact for it. That becomes the clitoris, and then they punch a hole between, I think, your bladder and your colon, and put the penis skin inside the hole. So that becomes your vagina.
Yeah. I know people say it works like a natural...
It does.
...vagina.
Yeah, it does.
Does it, like, self-lubricate, or do you have to use...
Sometimes it does, sometimes it doesn't. Yeah. You just get a bit of KY jelly or Aquagel or whatever and just use that. You just go in the bathroom before you have sex with someone. Come out. Oh, you're wet.
But not every transgender person wants genital surgery, and Drew's not sure whether it's right for her.
Having a penis doesn't feel right. for me.
Before, that was how I felt.
Mm.
But I think I'm more comfortable with myself now that it's not an issue. Like, no one has to see it apart from me. And, you know, whoever I'm with.
With me, I don't want no one else to see that, because that's not part of me. That's how I see myself. It's weird, isn't it? It's like I'm in a bath. I don't want to see it. I don't want to look at it. It's not going to change me as a person, but it's going to make my inside feel a lot happier. So maybe it will change me a bit.
Well, we'll find out, won't we?
Yeah, we'll find out, won't we? Definitely.
By late afternoon, everyone's getting ready to celebrate Karen's last night out before surgery.
OK, what shirt are you actually going to wear?
I don't know, actually.
All right, let's have a look then.
But Lewis is having a wardrobe crisis.
There's 10 different kinds of plaid here, so...
Mum usually irons my shirts. Well, I iron my T-shirts, but, like, shirts are a bit complicated, aren't they? Like, I need to get away from my mum, I think. Just get...
You need to grow the fuck up, mate.
As the girls get ready, Drew wants to give Sarah a helping hand.
I'm going to... do my best to give Sarah a makeover. Just to kind of show her some things that she can do. You know, because she doesn't know much about makeup, so... Yeah, right.
What?
You excited?
Yeah.
I'm well nervous.
I don't want to hurt you.
How long have you been transitioning?
A month.
A month?
Yeah.
Have you got anyone to, like, help you then?
No.
Really? No one?
No one really, no.
See, I've got my family, so...
See, my family don't really talk to me very much. I'm not looking for acceptance from them. I just want to inform them of my decision. I don't want to hide it from them. So how did you come out to your parents, then?
Well, I didn't actually come out to them.
Yeah.
They came to me. Like, I got so depressed to the point where I tried to kill myself.
Yeah.
One night, my mum went... are you gay? And I just said no. And she went, do you want to be a girl? And I just started crying. If I'd have known what I know now then, I would have come out when I was, like, 8. I'm surprised no one even knew then. I used to dance to Spice Girls, getting all the girls and be like, come on, I'll be Mel C.
Sarah's
had
a bit
ready?
Of a makeover.
Oh, yeah.
We're ready.
Woo!
Oh,
wow.
Yeah. Wow, nice. Hot wow. Damn. Yeah. Look at you.
What do you reckon?
Wow. I've come over all straight.
I feel really good now.
Sometimes you just need a couple of trannies to give you a hand.
It feels strange to be feeling good about myself. Really. When I arrived, I said I looked like a crap tranny in a bad wig. Well, I don't feel like that anymore. I actually like myself again. No, I think I look awesome.
Let's do this.
This is Karen's last chance for a night out for a while.
Oh, look, I spill.
Cheers to new friends, I think.
Yeah, I think
it's just...
I'm
looking fabulous.
We can all put makeup on and your boys can shave and us girls can shave.
At 52, Karen's the first to admit she's dressing like a younger woman.
That's cute.
Da-da.
But she's just making up for lost time.
I just love being female, getting dressed up, heels. I love low-cut tops, showing... my body off maybe a little bit too much sometimes for my age, but I have fun. I'm just enjoying my life as a woman for as long as I'm on this planet.
Lift your head up.
Lewis is enjoying his share of male grooming.
Lean back. Is it actually coming off?
Yeah. It's taken a while. Before, all my laser and stuff like that, I had quite thick facial hair. It was horrible. Really hated it. It was about as thick as yours, actually.
Watching other people put their makeup on is a bit like watching paint dry. The amount that they're using as well.
No, I love you like I do. No, I don't
love you. Champagne.
Don't know why I love you.
are going to have a massive...
I wonder why I love you like I do.
The group have finally made it to London's West End. And even in Soho, they make for a striking sight. Some of them are loving the spotlight.
You're amazing. Look at you.
You're
your
legs.
A leg.
Sorry.
And her boobs.
And her boobs.
Yeah.
And her face. Sorry.
And your boobs as well.
Yeah. And your boobs.
But being in a big group attracts attention, and it's making it easy for people to see that they're transgender.
If you're a big group of trans, if some people are more obvious than others, then it points everybody else out. People pick up on things they usually wouldn't pick up on.
When there's a group of seven people, and four of them are girls that are over 6 foot, and one of them's a guy that's not passing and really unhappy and uncomfortable with it, it's the anti-stealth, right?
It is anti-stealth, it definitely is. I know when I start talking it's a bit anti-stealth, you know? Oi.
It's not long before an incident occurs that shows how quickly things can turn.
You see that guy over there? Fuck me, darling. And he was just like, whoa, 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 whoa. It was amazing. It was like, who needs security when you've got that?
I think she has to be careful saying those sort of things to them.
Yeah.
I've narrowly escaped a few sort of brawls before, but luckily I'm quite good at talking so I can get out of it. But I think
when you're new,
I think
as
it was
well,
fabulous.
It's still a novelty, but when you've been doing it for 2, 3, 5 years, it gets exhausting and it's not worth it. But when you're still coming out, you want to fight every battle. Sarah, you're my hero!
You're fantastic.
Amazing.
Sunday morning, and there are sore heads at the retreat.
Are you feeling fresh?
I know. Enjoyed last night.
Did you?
After just 2 days at the house, Sarah's feeling better about her future.
I had a really good night, and a really, really good night last night. It was like a rebirth, you know? It was like a new evolution of me, and just... it was like a new lease on life, I felt. It was really good.
While Max cooks breakfast, Karen's getting ready for the most important doctor's appointment of her life. She's about to leave for Charing Cross Hospital in London.
The day before the operation, I thought I'd be a little bit... I don't know, a little bit sort of jumpy or frightened. But I'm not. I'm so calm. It's been a lovely weekend. I met some great new friends. That might have taken some of the pressure off, but I am so ready for this operation. I really am ready for this operation.
You all right?
Oh, yeah, all right. Okay. How are you?
Are you ready? Right.
Just getting ready.
Oh, you're all packed up.
Yeah, I've got towels, pads for after the operation. My first feminine stuff.
Is any of your family coming to
visit? I don't think so. I don't really see much of my family, really. I mean, I've got a daughter, but I've not seen her for years.
Why
at least
not?
20 years. I got divorced in 85. I used to see my daughter every weekend, up to the point where my ex-wife got remarried and moved away, a long way away.
Does it upset you?
I find it hard because I've not had any contact with her for so many years, and it's going to be so difficult facing her.
But do you think that day will come?
Hope so. I know I'm going to blub like hell if I do see her. I don't know what to say to her. I really don't know what to say to her. I really don't.
At least she knows that you love her, though.
Hmm.
And hopefully...
Hmm.
don't you set me up now?
God, I'll do my makeup again. Sod it.
Drew and Donna help Karen get ready to leave. The next time they see her, she'll have the body she's always wanted.
I think we should all get your number and text you tomorrow.
I mean, you know what I'm going to text you? How's your vag?
Bloody hurting.
Oh, my God, how cool would it be if you wake up tomorrow and not only you have a vagina, but it's been vajazzled as well? Wake up and it's all, like, diamond-y. Oh, yeah. It's like, bling, bling. Like, they pull the sheet off and it's like, ah.
So, good luck, but you don't need it.
You've really blossomed, Dad.
Yeah.
You've changed, yeah. So much more confident.
Well, I know, I feel it.
Well done.
All right. Good luck, eh?
Good luck, lads. Yeah.
Bye, girls, boys.
She's so brave.
I know.
So,
that's amazing. Oh, emotional.
Karen's a patient of the Gender Identity Clinic at Charing Cross Hospital. They perform four gender reassignment operations a week.
End of the day, this is the first day of the rest of my life. I'm reborn today. Totally reborn.
Surgeon James Bellringer has performed over 800 vaginoplasties, one of the most controversial procedures available on the NHS.
We often get criticised, why are you doing this operation which is cosmetic, it's not life-saving, but actually if you look at it in terms of quality of life, we have probably the best operation there is.
Move the hand over a bit, that's sort of quite close, that's it, lovely, thanks.
These patients before the operation are miserable, so an operation which theoretically costs £10,000 is delivering 40 years of very much improved quality of life. There's no cancer operation delivers that much.
Strobe test and cyanide, Stuart.
I've just finished dissecting the cavity. That's the space for the new vagina made. As I stop the bleeding, I'm going to remove the testicles, which are there and there. Now the testicles are sitting in a pot over there. We've certainly gone irretrievable. You can't sew those back on.
Back at the retreat, Karen's family situation has got everyone thinking.
I did not know that Karen had a daughter.
Yeah, I didn't know that either.
Well, she has no contact with her.
I'd love Karen to be my mom.
It's awkward for me.
How cool would that be?
Yeah.
She's very motherly.
She is.
Yeah, she'd make a good mum.
That'd be amazing.
One of the hardest things about changing gender is how to tell the people you love.
My family don't know about me yet.
They've never seen you like this,
no,
have they?
No, I want to tell them next week, actually.
Really?
Yeah.
Have you given it much thought about how they'd respond to that? Or?
Yeah, I'm pretty sure my dad won't have anything to do with me, or my older sister, or my younger brother.
And you should do it for you.
Exactly.
And their response should kind of be secondary.
You're telling them, not asking
you do something.
Them.
You can't keep living your life for other people. You need to live it for yourself.
Oh, yeah, for sure. I want to show my mum how happy I am. The world's full of colour again. The rest of my life is going to be good. You know, she's seen me go through a whole string of girlfriends, jobs. She's seen me depressed. She's seen the scars. I want to tell her it's over now. Even if they cut me out and don't talk to me ever again, at least I'll have told my mum I'm happy.
Over just 48 hours, seven trans people have started to become a group of friends.
Mainly, what I think I've got out of the weekend is just six new amazing people in my life.
I think when I get back home, people will notice a big change. Obviously, before I came here, like, if I saw someone looking at me, I'd be like, oh, they're looking at me because they know I'm a man. Whereas now, I think I'll just, like, think that they might look at me because they fancy me.
They each had their different reasons for coming to the retreat, but now they have to go back to the pressures of changing gender in the wider world.
The strength that I've seen from these people is just, it's phenomenal. I really see the struggle that they go through, and there's so much humour and so much lightness as well. I'm just so happy to be part of this. It's great.
Oh, you're my favourite.
Help you, I'm transgender.
This first weekend has been a great success. But it's only the beginning. Next time, with everyone back home.
Hi,
I'm Drew. It's nice to meet you.
You're Joe.
Drew.
Drew's struggling to get a job.
But you didn't look like a man.
No, you don't at all. But you see Adam's apple, you can always tell, can't you?
Sarah risks everything to tell her mum.
It's a huge day for me because, you know, this could be the last time I see my family in a long time.
And in their second retreat, Lewis gets the lowdown on getting his own penis.
I don't want a huge one, a decent size, but like happy medium sort of size.
If you want to know more about transgender issues and for support information, head to channel4.com/trans. Coming up on More 4, come dine with me.